Hi, it's Janie. Welcome back to my channel. And if you're new to my channel, hello. My name is Janie, and I like to do a variety of videos, basically kind of geared around beauty, but I also do lifestyle and book reviews or what I'm reading with a little bit of luxury thrown in there. So if you would, please hit that subscribe button. Also hit the little bell icon so that you're notified of all future videos. I do upload Mondays, Tuesdays, and Thursdays for the most part. Sometimes I miss a day. But anyway, so let's get started. Today's video is going to be what I am reading and what I have read, and I'm going to start out with this book here. And if you hear some grumblings, I do have the sugar babies with me. If you don't know, I am the proud new mother of two baby sugar gliders, and they are in their little pouch. We are in the bonding process, so try to wear them as much as I can. And one of the things that they say to help with the bonding process is to talk and let them listen to your voice. So I thought, well, what better way than to have them on me while I'm doing a video and talking to you guys, so they can get used to my voice. Anyway, so back to the book. This is a new author. That is new to the States. This is her first, I think this is her first book that she's come out with. Her name is Jane Corey. And she's a writer and a journalist that has spent time as the writer in residence of a high security prison for men. An experience that helped inspire this book here, My Husband's Wife. Her Dubay thriller. This is her first U.S. publication. I will tell you that I hope she comes out with a lot more books, because this was really good. And like I said, it's called My Husband's Wife, and it is based in London, that area, and it's about a young couple that just recently got married. And it's about their careers. She is a lawyer and he is an artist, and kind of how their career paths evolve. Their marriage as newlyweds, you know, how it kind of evolves. They meet up and become friends with a little neighbor girl, and how her life evolves. Anyway, it's just really good. It also has a trial that is an appeal of a gentleman that is in prison for the murder of his girlfriend. And anyway, I'm not going to tell you a whole lot about it because I don't want to give anything away, but it was an easy read. It wasn't hard, but it was very captivating, as far as, you know, there was enough turns and twists in this book that you didn't get bored. There were things that would happen that you didn't see coming. Also, it kind of evolved as you start reading, and the more you get into it, the more you learn from their past life, from their life now, and then further on down the road. Anyway, it's a really good book. I really enjoyed it. I had seen this at Sam's, and what I do is I don't purchase hardly any books. There's just one series of books that I purchase. The rest of the books I go to my local library and check out. And one of the things about the libraries is that you can request a book, and I like doing that. So if I go to Sam's and I look at the books, which I do every single time I go to Sam's, and there's a book that I'm interested in, I will snap a picture of it so I remember it. And then when I go to the library, then I'll request it. And that was what I did with this book. And it was, like I said, it was really good. It's by Jane Corey. Let's see if I can show you that without a glare. Can you see that? And again, it's called My Husband's Wife. And it had, let's see, how many pages was in this book? 373 pages. So not a whole lot, but definitely a good one to read. I don't know if you can, I'm just going to show you the print size of the words. But I don't know if my camera is going to focus on that or not. So, anyway, so. Chapter, and the chapters didn't seem to be like they were overly long. You know, sometimes you get books and the chapters just go on and on and on and on. And if you're like me, I don't like to stop reading until I'm through with a chapter. And if I'm done reading for the day, that's how I like to stop. I like to stop with the end of a chapter. I don't like to stop mid-chapter. And so the chapter pages were like on average 3 to 4 pages long, so not too overly long on the chapters. Anyway, okay. So the next book I want to talk about is one, a series that I do purchase, and every time she comes out with a new one, which is usually twice a year, I do purchase, and I like to get them at Sam's because they're a little bit cheaper. And this is from J.D. Robb. You've heard me talk about her for a very long time. This is the In-Depth series. This is called Secrets in Death. And basically it is a futuristic murder, mystery, action, love type book all rolled into one. It's about a New York cop who is now a lieutenant, and her name is Eve Dallas, and she can kick ass. I wish I was her. She's married to the richest man in the universe, and I say the universe because in this book there's other planets and they go off planet, and he owns boatloads of planets and businesses and buildings, and it's just really good. I mean, it's mainly focused around her and the different murders that happen in her city that she helps to catch their murderer, and they're just really good. Really enjoy that series, and I highly recommend them. I recommend though that you read them in order. The first one is Naked in Death. That's where you need to start at. I love, even though I have read all of them and there's about, I don't know, 25 in the series, Naked in Death is probably my favorite one, and I like to go back from time to time and read that. So anyway, I like it, and I feel like I have a connection with the characters because I've read so many of them. I feel like I know them. So I'm going to be really sad whenever she stops the series, but anyway, recommend those. Easy read also, very easy read. And then the next book that I want to talk about is a new author. New to me. I follow Candy from The Candy Show on Instagram and on YouTube, and she does a series called Candy Reads, and she had posted on Instagram a picture of her reading a book from this author, and it was new to her. She hadn't read any of her books either, and was going on how good they were, and I thought, well, I'm going to check that out because there's been a lot of books that she has recommended that I've read that I've enjoyed. Anyway, it's from the author called Louise Penny, which is kind of funny because Louise is my middle name and Penny is the name of my dog. Anyway, and this is a series, and the first one in the series is called Steel Life. And basically, it takes place, it's set in Canada, in the Quebec area, and it is a little village, I forgot what the name of the village is, Pine Hills, I think. Someone is called. Anyway, it is a murder mystery, and it is basically about, kind of circled around this inspector or police officer, detective, whatever we wanted to refer to him as, and I'm not for sure how to say his name, but Gamanchi is his last name, Gamanchi, I don't know. Anyway, there's a series of these books about him and how he investigates different murders and how he goes about it. Three Pines is where this takes place at. I don't think there's actually a place in Canada called Three Pines. I think it's fictional, but anyway. Anyway, he's the Chief Inspector Ahmed Gamachi. Gamachi. Don't know how to say that. Anyway, it's really good. I'm about halfway through, and there is 337 pages. And I don't know how many there are in the series. I have a list of them. I like it when they have a list, which this is the first one. I had to Google it and figure out what the first one was, and then my library didn't have it, but I requested it and got it. And also, I like reading paperbacks because this is the perfect size to fit in my purse, and I can take it with me on the go. That way, if I'm with my husband and we have to go to the water plant and he's doing his water stuff, I'm usually out in the vehicle. And most of the times, those water plants are way out in the woods and there's no Wi-Fi or internet. So I like to have a book to read. Anyway, so let me put my glasses back on. I was going to tell you a little bit about the author. She is the number one New York Times and Globe and Mail best-selling author of 10 Chief Inspector Ahmed Gamachi novels. She has won numerous awards, including a CWA Dagger and the Agatha Award. She won the Agatha Award 5 times, which I guess would be similar. I'm sure the Agatha Award is probably based from Agatha Christie. Did y'all ever read any Agatha Christie books? I think my favorite one was And Then There Were None. That was a good book. Anyway, so. And she was a finalist for the Edgar Award for Best Novel. She lives in a small village south of Montreal. And then she has a website called louisepenny.com. Blah, blah, blah. Anyway, so I am looking very forward to reading the next one in the series for sure. And I cannot wait to get through this one because I want to find out who committed the murder. I'm very interested. It was a little old lady that someone killed too, and her name is Jane. So I was really kind of sad that she was killed. I mean, so I'm just wondering who did it and why did they kill this nice little lady that's in this book? Anyway, so that is it for what I'm reading. I hope that you have enjoyed. Don't forget to give me a big old thumbs up, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye.